Glory be to God. We bless the name of the Lord. We give him praise. We give him glory. We give him honor. We give him adoration. King of kings, King of glory, Lord of hosts. The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. The Lord Jesus, who has never lost any war before. Jesus, the author, the perfecter, the finisher of our faith. King of kings, King of glory. We love you, Jesus. We celebrate your majesty. Good morning, Holy Spirit. Spirit of Christ Jesus. For the next few minutes, do what is in your plan. Let your holy name be glorified. Give us more grace to portray Christ in every aspect of life. Glory be to your holy name. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we are praying with thanksgiving. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. I welcome you all to Kingdom Advancement Service at Bethel Prayer Ministry International, our virtual service. Glory be to his holy name. Hallelujah. Wherever you are, I welcome you. I invite you to worship with Bethel Prayer Ministry International, wherever you can find yourself. You can worship with us in any of our branches, and your life is never going to be the same. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Glory be to his holy name. This morning, I want us to reflect on the topic, portraying Christ in you through actions and inactions. As a believer, as a child of God, if you purport, if you claim you are a believer, you are born again, you are a Christian, you are a sanctified one of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the whole Ghana, the nation Ghana as a whole, if we believe that the nation Ghana belongs to the Lord God Almighty, then we need to portray Christ through actions. What we do endorse, and when we do not endorse, what we frown upon, what we detest, what we reject, what we relegate onto the background should distinguish us from others to be able to know that you believe in the Lord Jesus. You are portraying Christ Jesus in you. Then you can say, Christ in me, the hope of glory. My brother, my sister, you cannot claim, you cannot purport. You have the Lord Jesus Christ in you. You are promoting homosexuality. You are promoting lesbianism. You are promoting drunkenness. You are promoting backbiting. You are promoting all sort of filthy lifestyle. How can you purport? How can you say that you have the Lord Jesus Christ in you? You do not have Jesus Christ in you. And once you do not have the Lord Jesus, then you have evil spirit in you. Once you do not have the Spirit of Christ in you, then you have evil spirit in you. My brother, my sister, you need to portray that you have the Lord God Almighty in you. You have the Lord Jesus Christ in you. And how can you do so? Through actions. Actions speak rather than words. Not just saying, not just purporting, not lip service. That I know God. Ghana is a religious nation or country. We do say, but what do you purport? What do you say? Now, considering the ongoing debate, discussion in the country as to whether our brothers and sisters who decide to be deviant, go contrary to the word of God by promoting same-sex marriage. And what have you? Do they have rights or not? Mr. President, His Excellency Nana Akufo-Addo, I humbly wish to entreat you, call them to order. You can invite them. Even the leader, the one is Alex Kofi-Donkor also. But some people mistakenly took him to be a brother of mine, a friend and a brother. Kofi-Donkor. My bro, I agree to God bless you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You can invite Kofi-Donkor. You can invite Alex Kofi-Donkor to your office, His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Ghana, Nana Akufo-Addo, and talk to him. He can be your son. He can be your grandson. That he should intend to tell his people, talk to his people, to repent and believe the gospel. We should not entertain it. We should not entertain this in the nation Ghana, because we believe that Ghana belongs to God. Ghana belongs to the Lord God Almighty. If the nation Ghana belongs to God, then certain things must not be entertained, must not be welcome at all. We shouldn't endorse them in our discourse. So we pray that the Holy Spirit himself will touch our leaders. Glory be to his holy name. Now, my brother, my sister, before I continue discussion, portraying Christ in you, but let me read something briefly a part of an abstract that I wrote an article in the, I think 2 years ago, glory be to God. I wrote an article. It's a research article in Natural Fire. Let me just read just the abstract and then we'll see what to do. Through investigative and explorative research, it was uncovered that same-sex marriage could be the surest way to check overpopulation and to annihilate mankind from the world, to kill the whole world, to kill everybody everywhere in this world, to destroy precious lives. If people everywhere, listen to the findings, if people everywhere do not marry naturally, that is male and female union, by 50 years to come, the whole world population would drastically dwindle, diminish, and hence leading to upright extirpation and annihilation of human beings in the next 120 years. It was found that one surpassing benefit, which is primus inter pares in marriage, is continuous procreation and fruitfulness. And for that reason, as same-sex marriage could not ensure continuous procreation, it would be expedient to kick it out from human society. It was found that once a glory be to God, hallelujah, let me continue. It was suggested by many respondents, the participants of this research, that it would be highly beneficial to pray for all those in authority. To pray for all those in authority. Now let's pray for Nana Akufo-Addo. Let's pray for His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Ghana, our MPs. Let's pray for all those in authority so that they would not be influenced negatively to make such decisions that are disgraceful, shameful, and destructive to the present generation and posterity as a whole. Both secular and religious participants or respondents did not endorse same-sex marriage, but rather describe it as loathsome, inhuman, degrading, and destructive practice. It is highly incumbent upon all African countries, particularly Ghana, the nation Ghana, to adopt a long-term or never-ending timeless marriage law that prevents any African citizen to engage in same-sex marriage, lesbianism, homosexuality, and what have you. Without that, future leaders, listen carefully. This is like a prophetic word or research. Without that, future leaders who may pursue personal aggrandizement, personal interest or personal aggrandizement, who are so self-seeking, selfish, and are fond of pursuing personal aggrandizement or interest, hallelujah, or face some financial constraints, when they do face financial constraints, financial challenges, financial difficulties, would be compelled to introduce same-sex marriage in African continent. May God have mercy on us. Ghana belongs to the Lord God Almighty. So whoever you are, our leaders, be careful that you do not pursue personal interests, that you will never be compelled because of financial challenges or difficulties, because of foreign assistance or aid, and then you accept this destructive and degrading practice into our nation. May God have mercy on us. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Our topic for today is, I'll be very brief, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's read from 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31 to 33. Quickly, 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31 to 33. Let's listen to the word of God. So whether you eat or drink, whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. Do not cause anyone to stumble. Do not cause anyone to stumble, whether Jews, Greeks, or the church of God, even as I try to please everybody in every way. For I am not seeking my own interest. For I am not seeking my own good, but the good of many. Let's seek the good of Ghana. Let's seek the good of Africa. Let's seek the good of humanity. Let's seek the good of posterity. This is what the Paul the Apostle said. We claim we belong, we are Christians, we are children of God, we know the Lord God, we claim we are Muslims, we claim we are Christians, we claim we are traditional worshippers because we believe in God. In actual fact, if you study religion, our forefathers, our ancestors had the knowledge of God. That's why they call God the supreme being. The almighty God. The only issue is that how they go about the religion, how they go about the worship. Instead of serving the King of Kings, the King of Glory, they believe that he's so high, he's so great to be approached directly. So they need some mediums, which is so unfortunate. Glory be to God. But the only way is the Lord Jesus Christ himself. So my brother, my sister, we shouldn't pursue personal interest, personal need, personal aggrandizement to the detriment of masses, the detriment of the masses. But we should seek the good of many so that they may be saved. Let's seek the good of others so that they may be saved. Our brothers and sisters who are promoting all sorts of filthy things, let's talk to them. Let's draw them to order, call them to order. Let's advise them. Let's tell them, Lord Jesus loves you. So whatever our brother Alex Kofi Donkor is going through right now, anybody could have come through. Anybody could experience this. It's just by the grace of God that you are alive. It's just by the grace of God that you are not promoting lesbianism, homosexuality, all sort of filthy things. So what can you do to help them? Let's invite them. Mr. President, invite him. Invite the leader. Talk to him. Talk to him. Advise him. If we claim we know God, we need to help them to know the Lord God Almighty. And we should not think about what you get now. Let's consider posterity. Let's consider our children. What will be the outcome, the repercussion when you do promote same-sex marriage? Now, when you read the word of God, they may say they have their rights, they have this, they have, everything is biblical in some way. Let's read the word of God quickly from 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 12. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 12. What does the word of God say? The word of God says that everything is permissible for me. Everything is permissible for you, my brother, my sister. Everything is permissible for you. But not everything is beneficial. So we can tell our brothers that it's beneficial. Everything is permissible for you. Even those of us who are married, everything is permissible for you. But should you, instead of using your manhood, instead of using your penis to do whatever you're supposed to do to play your role effectively as a husband, then you decide to use your mouth, you decide to use your eyes, you decide to use your nose. Is it right? You decide to eat or consume human excreta. It's beneficial, so can you do so? You claim you have the right, my brother, my sister. We need to repent and come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Everything is permissible for me, but I will not be mastered by anything. Food for the stomach, and the stomach for the food. And the stomach for food. For food for the stomach, and the stomach for food. But God will destroy them both. God will destroy them both. You that you think you have your right, my brother, my sister, the Lord Jesus is coming soon. Repent and believe the gospel. God will destroy them both. You will die and go to hell. And you that you think you are in authority, so you can influence people, You would think that you want foreign assistance, foreign aid, so it doesn't matter. If you don't accept it, they won't help us. They won't do this. Where is Ghana Beyond Aid agenda? Ghana Beyond Aid, where is it? Ghana Beyond Aid, where is it? Don't depend on foreign assistance. They cannot help us. They depend on God Almighty. Glory be to His holy name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The body is not meant for sexual immorality. The body is not meant for sexual immorality. The body is not meant for filthy lifestyle. The body is not meant for demonic practices. Because you have the right, you want to do your own thing, not the natural means. No, my brother, my sister, the Lord Jesus loves you. The Lord Jesus loves you. Repent and come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Glory be to His holy name. But the Lord, listen carefully, for the Lord and the Lord for the body. The body belongs to the Lord God Almighty. Those who are not believers, who are not Christians, will not understand this. So we need to pray for our leaders. We need to help them. We need to show them love. That they need to come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Therefore, God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish, but will have everlasting life. Glory be to His holy name. Whoever you are, my brother, my sister, we need to come to the saving knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. We need to pray for the nation Ghana. We need to pray for Africa. We need to pray for the whole world that we will not go wayward. People are pursuing personal interest, personal aggrandizement to the detriment of the masses. Even COVID-19 is associated with so many issues. People who want to make name. People who want to destroy lives, may God have mercy on them. So if you are there and you do not pray, you do not trust the Lord, and you want to depend on foreign aid, foreign assistance, you are not helping your people or your nations, wherever you are in Africa. You are not. You are not. Even the COVID-19 vaccine, Africans, our researchers, our scholars, where are they? What can we do? Why can't we depend on what you have in Ghana, what you have in Africa? But we would rather opt for foreign, everything foreign is impeccable, everything that the foreign is acceptable. No, we shouldn't. We can use so many foreign things to destroy Africans, and we need to be careful. Say, God have mercy on that. My brother, my sister, everything is permissible for you, but not everything is beneficial. Everything is permissible for you, but don't forget that you shouldn't be allowed to be mastered by anything. Glory be to His holy name. May the Almighty God have mercy on us all. Let's pray that, Father, have mercy on me. Lord Jesus, have mercy. If you don't know Jesus, just give your life to the Lord Jesus. Pray for mercy. Pray for great grace and mercy. The Lord God Almighty, have mercy on me. Today, I, Michael Osutebiri, I repent of my sins. I give you my spirit. I give you my soul. Everything I do, Father, help me to portray Christ in everything I do. In the name of Jesus, whether I'm eating, whether I'm going to bed, Lord God, I want to portray you. I want to live for you all the days of my life. Lord Jesus, help me. Holy Spirit, help me. Father, I give you my spirit. I give you my soul. I give you my body. In the name of the Lord Jesus, let's portray Christ. Let's portray Christ. That will claim Christ is in you. Portray Christ. Portray Christ. Show that Christ is really in you, in your actions and in actions. Portray Christ. You claim you are a religious person, a religious leader, a Christian, a Muslim. Show that you have the Lord God Almighty in you. By discarding any demonic practice and not pursuing personal interests, May the God of all grace be gracious unto us all. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May the Holy Spirit help you. May the King of Kings help us. May the King of Glory help us all to portray Christ in everything that you do in life. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Glory be to his holy name. God bless you to continue to be a blessing in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Goodbye.